Hey, Dr. Dan here. This is the start of my series on business writing. My goal here is to help you become a better writer in business contexts, introduce some common genres or formats, documents that you might encounter in business and professional settings, how you can write better, how you can think about your audiences, how you can be a more effective communicator. And the relationship between the quality of your writing and your employability is something I cannot overstate. If you improve your writing, you're so much more likely to get accepted into higher and higher positions because you'll master the art of the resume and the cover letter. You'll conduct yourself in a professional and respectable manner, and you'll be able to think more clearly too, which is something really important. The idea from Walter Ong is that writing is a technology that restructures thought. It's important to realize the relationship between the way we think and the way we write, and the relationship between language and thought. And so by becoming a more effective writer, you also teach yourself to structure your thoughts in a way that are coherent and organized and logical. And most businesses need to rely on rationality, on good decision making to survive. It's extremely competitive out there. So increase your chances on the job market, become a better, say, employee or entrepreneur, communicate more effectively with audiences, communicate more effectively with customers and in business-to-business settings and with your colleagues. So this is part one on business writing. I teach a class called Writing 209, Professional and Business Writing. Let's just break that down. What does that mean? What is a business? A business is just the legal structure under which goods or services are sold or commodities are moved around. It's a little trickier in what's being called now the knowledge economy, because maybe you're selling something that isn't exactly a good or a service. Like, let's say you're monetizing a YouTube video. Is software is not a tangible good necessarily. That doesn't always come in a box, but it might be a cloud service. So you have to really expand what we think of when we think of business and the way that businesses are conducted. But broadly speaking, the word business just refers to the legal entities. A business is a legal entity under which capital goes in and capital goes out. So that's what we mean by business. And then what is writing? Now, there's a long historical tradition of writing. This is interesting. From what I've read from a number of different sources on the history of language and anthropological studies, it might be that the very first written documents were business records. That's not exactly clear, and you know, some of the dating might be subject to skepticism, sure, but it's likely that some of our early cuneiform writing, which refers to, you know, basically mashing stone into a tablet, you know, perhaps these were business records. Some of our earliest writing is a recording of oratory as well, and that's interesting too. This is where we branch off, right? There's kind of the field of creative writing, and then we have technical, professional, and business writing. And you know, there's certainly overlap in these disciplines, but that's a clear kind of distinction. When a lot of people think about writing, they think about, oh, reading Shakespeare in high school or something like that, and how much they dreaded Elizabethan English. That's not what I'm talking about. And this is a really good, important breakthrough moment for my students too. Once they realize that there's a study of language and writing that's applicable to their lives in an immediate kind of way, and, you know, sorry Shakespeare, I've read quite a bit. Love Hamlet, you know, I'm talking down to old William Shakespeare, but this is an important breakthrough moment for a lot of my students. It's like, okay, writing is worth taking seriously outside of the public education context of literature. So it's like, let's separate that right off the bat. Writing is something that occurs in every business. Like, think about, you're writing a script for a television commercial. You're writing a resume. You're writing a sales report. You're writing the description of a product. You're writing a manual to describe how to use a product. You're writing an email to your coworker about a broken product. You're writing an email to a coworker about a broken system. It can go on and on and on. Almost everything we do is encoded in some way into language. I'm gonna argue almost perhaps everything we do is encoded into language or mathematics or some symbolic system, but I don't wanna get too deep into the philosophical in this one. That's for other places. So every business does a lot of writing. Every employee or business owner does a lot of writing. And really successful business owners are great writers as well, because they can communicate, say, what their service is about or what their product is and why it has a certain niche in a market, what is it? They can describe and compel people to listen to them, right? So writing is a part of every job. It doesn't matter what, even if you're a computer scientist in software engineering, a programmer or something like that, you're still, say, writing emails, chatting, you're making notes about the programming that you're doing. If you're an engineer, you have to do documentation and reporting. And there's classic examples of where bad report writing has caused millions or billions of dollars of damage within companies, or say what happened with the Challenger explosion, where the lives of several astronauts were lost because of a miscommunication about an O-ring, a component failure in the space shuttle. It shouldn't have launched at a certain temperature, right? It was too cold that day, and it was known by some of the engineers that the O-ring components would fail, but it was miscommunicated throughout NASA. So a lot is at stake with your writing, is what I'm saying. So an AP survey that I looked at where 400 companies were surveyed in the US, and the most valuable skill that these employers said they would like their employees to have was writing. They see a lot of bad writing. And here's the thing. Bad writing leads to miscommunication, leads to poor documentation. It can lead to, say, a bad reputation for the company. Imagine, you reach out, you're working on, say, a $2 million engineering contract, and the individual, say, the project manager who gets back in touch with you, has a misspelling, or say, three misspellings, or some grammar that doesn't seem quite right. You're going to mistrust that entire company based off of that email. You might not want to close on that $2 million deal. You might not want to say, go move ahead with this company. There's a really interesting story. I think it's the band Van Halen. I'm going to misremember parts of this, but so of course they have crews that go and set up these massive stages ahead of time for them. And one of the tasks that, or one of their requirements in the contracts they would sign with venues, say, is they would ask that the crews that build the stages take a bag of M&Ms or Skittles and sort them out, the entire bag out by color, and then leave them. And the idea is, if they didn't follow directions properly, if they didn't see that in their steps, then they might miss a step in the construction of the stage, in putting together the lighting and the rigging and the audio equipment and everything that goes into building a massive musical performance. So this is really interesting. I think this speaks exactly to what the significance of writing and clear writing and errorless writing, why that's significant in the workplace. It's like, it shows a crack in your mentality, perhaps, or it shows a crack in your reputation when there's excessive punctuation or a misplaced period or something doesn't line up, or there's a typo, an evident typo, or a malapropism, a word that sounds like another but doesn't mean the same thing. If these kinds of errors speak poorly about a company, and they speak poorly about individuals too. Now, I'm not what people call, say, a grammar nut. I'm after clear communication. That's what I want to teach you about, how to communicate effectively and clearly in business settings.